live in the South. And as you may know, the South is typically pretty warm. It doesn't really get cold in the South that much, except for this year. Shopping or to the store, it's like burning up inside. So you're constantly having So it's not as noticeable. those are Louboutin bags that have the LB, but typically I don't really like to, you know, have the brand all over me. So, yeah, so this is the first jacket that I'm showing you guys that is like my workhorse jacket. This thing keeps me warm. I love it. I don't have to use a lot of layers. So I can have like a very thin sweater and this on, and I'm set, I'm warm. So this is my first jacket that I want to show you. Now these are just like in random order. They're not ordered like special or anything. The next one is just a typical jean jacket. And this is a Gap 1969 jean jacket, 100% cotton, extra small. Now this jacket is, I would say, your typical standard jean jacket. And I usually roll up the cuffs. Now the reason I like a jean jacket, I'm telling you, this whole neighborhood was quiet before I started filming. And then all of a sudden my ice maker wants to go off. There's an emergency outside. Anyway, so I like jean jackets mostly because I think it adds a little, it adds to your look. But also because I don't like to go sleepless. In fact, even in the summer, I usually wear long sleeves. I know, it's weird. My husband thinks it's weird. He doesn't understand it, but I guess I'm weird. I don't know. But I'm working from home now, and it seems like that's going to be a permanent thing from now on. But when I was going into the office, I work in a pretty casual environment for the most part, unless I have to come meet with a client. I mean, short of wearing, you know, my pajamas, I can pretty much go in with anything I want. But that was the chair, by the way, it wasn't me. Anyway, so what was I gonna say? Yeah, so sometimes in the summer I would wear like a cute summer dress or a skirt and like a t-shirt, and I would put this on top of it and it looked cute. And you know, in Chicago I wouldn't wear this in the summer, so typically I wear this in the spring or the fall, mostly the spring, just because I feel like it's more of a spring thing. So yeah, this is just your typical jean jacket. It has tiny little buckets on the side. It has these chest buckets, which I never use, and that's it. There's nothing like truly special or phenomenal about this jacket, except that I feel like everyone needs a jean jacket in their closet. I like jean jackets. In fact, I've always had a jean jacket in my closet, and I think I always will. I think they're cool. So this is the second jacket. The other one I have that I wanted to show you is this leather jacket. Now, this is not your typical, like, you know, Harley Davidson leather jacket, if you will. And I don't often wear this, but when I do, it's usually in the fall. It's not in the spring for some reason. I don't know why. I guess because of the color. I don't know. But so this jacket actually has a very special story. My husband got it for me in Italy, Noi Firenze. And like you can see right here, it says, made in Italy, vera pelle, which means real leather, fodera 100%. 100% viscosa. So this is 100% viscose. A norma della... della... che... what does it say? Della... what is that? Legge. Now, I know a little bit of Italian because I studied it in college for a year, and then I also lived in Italy very briefly. So I know how to read it. I understand some of it. But anyway, back to the story about this jacket. So my husband and I went to Italy in 2012. I had been there. I had briefly lived in Italy in 2003. So I wanted to show him around and take him to where I lived and all that other stuff. And maybe live isn't the correct word. I stayed in Italy. Florence, mainly. But anyway. So, we went and the owner of the hotel we were staying in owned this leather company. So we checked it out. And he showed us this leather coat. And he was like, yeah, you know, he was really nice. And so my husband was like, do you want it? And I'm like, yeah. So he bought it for me, which was super sweet. Mind you, we didn't have a lot of money back then. But, you know, he was like, this is special. You know, it's a one time. Like, I don't know. We're not in Italy every day. So I love this jacket for that reason. Now, I haven't worn it in a little long time, so I think I'm going to start wearing it more often. And the leather is super soft. Like super, super supple and soft. That's a weird word, isn't it? Supple. 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 Yeah, anyway. So yeah, I like this jacket. It has two side pockets in the front. It has, I guess the detailing is, you know, like kind of patchwork. In a way, and maybe that's why it wasn't that as expensive, because it wasn't like one full, you know, one full like piece of leather, which I'm okay with. But I like this jacket, and it's really light, and I think it adds to an outfit. Now I should say that it hasn't been until recently that I have been into like fashion. I used to be when I was a lot younger, and then I stopped, and now I'm getting back into fashion again. So I feel like this is a really good staple to have in your wardrobe, a nice leather jacket. So this is another one that I have that I wear mostly in the fall. Is this one. Now, I like this one. This one is from Banana Republic. And this is kind of like the, you know, the English brand Barber. They do like English countryside fashion, I guess. It's like this waxy material. You know, just like when you see Princess Diana and Prince Charles in there, I guess it was her honeymoon, and they were at Balmoral. I think it was Balmoral. And they're kind of, you know, talking to the press. Prince Charles has like a very similar jacket to this. I guess fishermen wear it. I don't know. Anyway, the point is, I always go on tangents, y'all. Anyway, so, this was such a good find. Now, I've had this jacket for, I don't know for how long, I would say, 2021, maybe like 8 years, 7 years, and, oh my god, I love this jacket. Now, I bought this at Banana Republic. And I bought jacket, and I wear it so much. And what I like about it is the color. I like that material. It's like waxy. It has these like two buckets down here. It has this plaid lining. It also, I like these like, what are they, elbow patches. And yeah, I like it a lot. It also has this corduroy, like neck. And I don't know, I think it's really cool. I wear this around like when I'm running errands, and I make sure to wear it anytime we go apple picking. Cause it just looks like something you would wear apple picking, right? Or when we go like hiking and stuff sometimes. So yeah, this jacket I wear all the time, and I love it. I don't usually wear it in the fall. In the spring. I typically wear it in the fall. But I love it. Love, love, love. I mean, I love all the jackets I have, but... Okay, this next one, you guys have already seen. I've shown you guys. This is my latest acquisition. It is this Maximara coat. Now, this has, I think it's a proper pocket that I haven't opened, but it also has side pockets. And it also has a lapel, but no, what is this, a chest pocket? But I haven't opened that one either. And then it has like the V in the back. Now let me tell you guys something. So I told you guys my whole story when I bought this jacket, right? That I like went and I wasn't planning on buying it, but I ended up buying it, blah, blah, blah. Well, so the saleswoman was saying this is made out of camel hair. And because it's made out of camel hair, it's very, very warm, she said. You can go outside and it's gonna, you know, in like 10 degree weather, and that's gonna keep you warm. And I thought to myself, sure, whatever, lady. I like the coat, so I'm gonna buy it, but I'm not really buying your whole claims that this is like the most super, you know, warm jacket ever. Didn't believe it. Well, I think I was wrong. Because it really is super warm. Now, when it's really, really cold outside, I'm going to wear my Canada Goose jacket because, you know, it's a no-brainer. It has a hood. It keeps my head warm. Plus, if it's nasty and snowing, I'm not going to wear this because I don't want to get this too dirty. But this is amazing. And I'm really like... The only thing that I'm kind of shocked about is the lining. They had another one that was cheaper than this, but it had like, I didn't like the lining. I know that you're not gonna see the lining, but I just didn't like it. And I was like, no, I want one with black lining. So this is what I got. And I like it because it keeps me warm, but it also, I have to show you guys something in a second. But it also looks pretty good. You know, it looks pretty nice. I like it. Now, the other day I was in Sephora and I was looking at foundation, of course. What else am I going to look at, right? And I like reached over and I got a little bit of foundation right here. I'm really upset about that. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I tried getting it out. Now, the saleswoman said not to get this dry cleaned every year. Apparently, you don't want to do that with really nice coats. So she said like every other year or every third year to get it dry cleaned. But I don't really think you can see it that much. And because this coat, you know, kind of goes a little bit further down in my hands for practical reasons, you know, to help keep your arms warm, I'm sure I'm going to get the sleeves dirty again. So I'm trying not to freak out about it too much. But yeah, this is like my first and only Max Marco. And I am not disappointed. I'm not gonna lie. I have to consider when, like, getting it dressed is that I can actually forego using a scarf because all I have to do is button this up and it like it covers my neck. You see? Like that. The only thing is though, if I'm wearing makeup, I have to be careful not to rub my face on this because I don't want to get makeup on it. So yeah, this is another one of my goats, which I love. And I wear with some frequency. But again, it's not something that I can wear when it's really cold. And in fact, I actually prefer to wear it like this. I think it looks nicer like this. It looks really cool. Now, last but certainly not least, we have another Burberry. Now, you know, it's really funny because I never, like, staple that I wanted to have. Now this is Burberry, London, England, the Kensington, made in England. Now I thought this was funny, or not funny, but cool, by appointment to Her Royal Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, Waterproofers, Burberry Limited, London, and then by appointment to His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales. What does that say? Sorry. Burberry Limited, London. Now, I don't know if I have any British viewers, but if I do, what is this? Any insight you can provide us Americans would be great. Yeah, that's cool though. I thought that was cool. That's made in England. Now, this is a size 6 US. But I will say this. Sizes in Europe run a lot smaller than they do in the States. That's all I'm gonna say. Anyway, so this coat has a very, very long story behind it. And the story is that, okay, so the story is that I went to Burberry. Because I used to live down the street from Burberry. And I was really keen on getting a trench coat. And I wanted a trench coat. So I went and I was like, I should just try out one of their trench coats. And so back then, back when I went, they had the different, I guess, Burberry categories, for lack of a better word, right? So like my last coat, that was a Brit. And then they had, like, another category. And, like, each category was kind of, like, determined the price point of that item. If I remember correctly. And if I have my facts straight, but I'm pretty sure that's how it worked. So, back then, I remember the trench coats being around $1,200 to $1,500. I was like, okay, it's a lot of money, but whatever. So I went, tried it on, for some reason or another, didn't buy it, probably because I didn't want to spend the money, and then all of a sudden, Burberry, I think, gets a new head designer, and he completely reimagines Burberry, and now everything's expensive. So, I was bummed, and I even had, like, the style of trench coat and the size I needed. So, I don't know if y'all remember, I mean, I'm sure you do, but like, what's it called? Oh my god, Barney's. Remember Barney's? Okay, well, they went out of business about a year ago, I think, more than a year ago. And they had this like sale, right? Like massive sale. Well, this coat is now around $2,000. I know, so much, I mean, like, you know, like, more, a lot more than they used to be. saw that they had it on sale, and I thought, oh great, I'm gonna buy it. But I had lost the card that rat down the name of the goat, because they have different styles, okay? I had lost the card that had the name of the goat, and I lost the end of that same card, also had the size. So I just kind of guessed, which is stupid, I know, stupid. But it was like heavily discounted, so I was like, okay, fine, whatever, if it doesn't fit, I'll sell it. Because it was like, once you bought it, that's it, like you couldn't, final sale rate. So it arrives, and I'm super duper happy. I get it out of the box, and this thing does not fit. I feel like it's too big. And this was about last year. And I was so super sad, and really upset. And you know, sometimes when you're just so sad about something and upset, like you just forget about it. It's like your mind mentally blocks it. So I very calmly put this back in the box, and I put it up in my closet, and I was like, I can't deal with this emotionally right now. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. So then I was like, okay, you know what? My husband told me you need to do something with that goat. We can't just have it up in the closet. So I said, okay, I'm gonna sell it. Well, that became this huge ordeal. It wouldn't sell. People are trying to lowball me. I'm like, I can't. So then I told my husband, I said, you know what? I don't care. I'm just going to contact my family and say, I have a Burberry coat. Who wants it? If you fit it, it's yours. First come, first serve. Don't care. I want it out of this house. I don't want to see it again. I don't care. I just want it out. So I was willing to just give this to a family member and say, Merry Christmas and Happy Birthday, it's yours. Because I don't fit in it. And by not fit in it, it was a little too big. So my husband said, well, hold on a second. Before you do that, why don't we go to a tailor and see if they can do anything about it? So we went into Burberry, and Burberry was like, no, we can't help you. So I was like, fine. They're like, the only thing we can do is shorten the hem. And I was like, well, that's not going to help. So I was kind of gutted over this. So my husband, being the lovely man that he is, researched some tailors around the city and found one. And he's like, well, let's go check this guy out. I'm like, okay. So we go, and I'm like, look, I have this trench coat. I love it, but it doesn't fit. So, you know, let me know if you can correct this error of mine. So what he did, he was like, okay, put it on. So I put it on, tied it up, and he's like, what do you mean if it's fine? And both my husband and I looked at each other like, oh my God, it does fit. What happened? Did I gain weight? What is going on? And so apparently, I don't know what happened. I mean, have I gained weight? No, I've actually lost weight. So I don't know if maybe I just didn't have enough clothes when I was trying it on. Because when I went to go get it hemmed, this was like in the middle of winter, so I had quite a few layers on. And the tailor said, I wouldn't touch it if I were you. And he said, I need the money, but I don't think you need it. And I said, okay, well, I know what I do need. And I definitely need the arms shortened. And I need the because they were too long. And I need the length shortened as well. And he did. And he did such a fabulous job. Look at that. You can't even tell, guys. The only thing where you can tell is where, right here. And that's because he had to remove this and move it up. So that's where it was before. And he also hemmed the bottom. But you can't tell. It's amazing. So, now, it's not, this coat is not form-fitting, okay? It's not like my gray jacket where it's like super form-fitting. This one is more like, not baggy, but it, you know, it's it's definitely doing what it's supposed to and serving the purpose that it's supposed to, which is supposed to be a raincoat that I can layer in. So, but that was a long story. Sorry, guys, if I bore you, maybe I bore you to sleep. Who knows? Anyway, what I like about this jacket is the construction. All of the man hours. Can you imagine? To do every little thing. Oy. And look at the construction. So I like all of these details. The fact that you can hook this up. I like the fact that the belt has these like D-rings, you know, to help prevent the belt from falling off. I mean, all of these details and the history behind this coat too, I think is really cool. So while I bought this coat a year ago, I just picked it up from the tailor and I wore it today. And I love it. I love it. Now I will say, I wouldn't say it's too big, but I guess I'm used to wearing very form-fitting jackets like the gray one. It's just gonna take me a little time to get used to it, but the story had a happy ending, which was I didn't have to lament buying the wrong size. I don't know what happened. It's a mystery. But this is it. This is my jacket and coat collection to wrap it up. Anyway, I hope you liked this video. Leave me a comment like usual. Subscribe, like the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.